really serious news from the studio, it seems. I'm only just getting to it now. It dropped about 12 hours ago, and it's really important, it seems, for the future of the game and the state of things at ArenaNet. Honestly, this is a video I never thought I'd be doing. It's quite a surreal experience, but check it out. This all started with a Kotaku article, this one here, that says Guild Wars 2 developer ArenaNet plans for mass layoffs, which really feels quite out of the blue here in the community and has spurred a lot of community reaction, cynicism, and discussion. So I want to talk about this here today, see what the Kotaku article states, look at some of the developer tweets, and see exactly where we are. So I'm going to start off, first of all, with before the Kotaku article and the general state that Guild Wars 2 and ArenaNet seem to have been in, because maybe the writing was on the wall, but it could have been difficult to see. So obviously we're in the Path of Fire expansion, which is over a year old now, and time is ticking on. There's been an expectation we'll have another expansion, but it seems to be later than we would have initially thought when Path of Fire first came out. Maybe not a big deal there. As for the game itself, in terms of the patches and the quality of them, I don't think there was any evidence at all that ArenaNet was struggling whatsoever. The frequency of the patches and size of the patches through Living World Season 4 have been consistent. There's been a couple of small delays, yes, but in general, the amount of features that they want in those maps, the size of those maps and whatnot, I think has been pretty much on par with where they set out. I would also say that the expansion itself was an expansion on the prior one, Heart of Thorns, in terms of its size and its features. And I'd also say that Season 4 feels about consistent with where Season 3 was. The, you know, size of the maps and the number of different things in the maps, and maybe the replayability is a little bit different in Season 3 to Season 4. But the general amount of effort and developer resources and whatnot that seems to have gone in Guild Wars 2 has been about on par. What I'm saying is, if you look at just the updates in the game itself, I think we've been smooth sailing and steady ever since Living World Season 3 started, after the post-Heart of Thorns content drought. Everything's been about the same. If not, there's been big improvements in the quality of the storytelling and whatnot. Now, maybe you disagree with what they settled on, and that's a discussion for another video. And yes, there's been a couple of delays. Some patches seem slightly weaker than others, but nothing to suggest the studio was in trouble. Everything to suggest that they'd found their balance and what they wanted, and they were earning enough money to continue the development. So that's where we are as far as the game's concerned. But Path of Fire, the last big expansion and point of sale for the devs, where they end up getting a lot of revenue, was a while ago now. And back in summer came some pretty profound news that there wasn't going to be an expansion immediately after Season 4, where we currently are, but they were going to go into Season 5 instead straight away. And that is a bit of a head scratcher. Why don't they have another expansion ready? Is there something more going on here that suggests maybe the status quo they've fallen into isn't good enough? I think the conclusion many of us came to from that news in summer, if any, was actually that maybe Living World, just all on its own, with the associated gemstore sales and minor, you know, peak of player activity every time a release comes out, maybe that alone is profitable enough to justify the rest of Guild Wars 2, and they don't have to do the full expansions. And that seems perfectly logical. You might not like that because expansions are so exciting and whatnot, but even still, it would leave Guild Wars 2 in a profitable, continually developed place that we keep getting content and enjoying the MMO. Nothing to suggest that there were layoffs on the horizon. Yet, here we are. Well, let's dive in and have a look. I'll also note that like a day before this dropped, Blizzard announced layoffs, I believe, and ArenaNet threw a public tweet out saying, hey, you guys can come here, which now seems really funny considering they're announcing their own layoffs. To look at the Kotaku article, they seem to have an anonymous tipster that has given them little insights into what's going on behind the company, and that's where this news is breaking from. And to quote the actually important parts of the article, they say, ArenaNet informed employees today that it is planning big layoffs. Although ArenaNet did not give out exact numbers and they may not yet be finalized, rumors, I don't know where these rumors come from, if there's no information even from this tipster, rumors floating around the studio signal that a significant number of people will be let go. So yeah, it hasn't happened yet, but they're having meetings about it. NCSoft West says in an email, our live game business revenue is declining as our franchises age. Delays in development on PC and mobile have created further drains against our revenue projects, while our operating costs in the West have increased. Where we are is not sustainable and is not going to set us up for future successes. So I just want to linger on this part of the article here, this quote from the spokesperson at NC Southwest. There's talk about both PC and mobile development here. I'm not sure if we're meant to interpret this message as purely being about ArenaNets or other things filtered in there too. There has been speculation for a long while now that ArenaNet's been working on other projects. I think it would be crazy to assume they weren't. Even since 2012 and Guild Wars 2 originally released, I think any intelligent company would have started spending a bit of money on something new, you know, a second franchise to juggle, not put all eggs into this one basket. I think that's fair. There have also been further suggestions and rumors that maybe ArenaNet was releasing a mobile game at some point that has never manifested to anything over the years. But this exact statement here, I don't know whether that's really confirmation ArenaNet is working on a mobile game or what. What I do think is very likely true is that ArenaNet has consistently and for many years been working on a second project, a new game, but it's been delayed and restarted or reshuffled or shaken up over and over and over again for whatever reasons. If you look back at 2012 before Guild Wars 2 came out, the way they talked about their game, the way that all the pre-release information came out, they were very, very keen on scrapping things they'd worked on if they didn't feel that they were perfect. They had a real philosophy and a mindset for reinventing the wheel and not being scared to break what they've created in the pursuit of perfection. Like, that was a huge thing with the company and one of the main PR spins that got people on board with Guild Wars 2 as a concept and, you know, breaking the MMO mold and whatnot. So, with all of that stuff, you can say ArenaNet's grown and the company culture will have shifted a bit, but I bet those through lines are still there. And I can very easily imagine that those same philosophies have held whatever their new or second idea is in limbo for years now. And who knows what kind of a money sink that or those projects has actually ended up being. And I think that might be the true story here. Before I get back to that, let's finish with the Kotaku article. They say that the company plans to cut costs across the organization. I think we are talking specifically about ArenaNet here. Restructure across the board. Merge ArenaNet and NCSoft's publishing divisions in the process. The restructuring, cost-cutting, and strategic realignments are all being done to secure our tomorrow and to provide the foundation that will allow us to grow and acquire. Right, so there's a lot of weird corporate PR speak there. What's interesting about this is actually before and around Heart of Thorns, I believe, when ArenaNet was still growing a lot, I think, at the time, there was a separation between how strictly NC Softwest controlled the publishing and various aspects of Guild Wars 2. I believe that there was a bit of a separation there. They never talked very publicly about it, and the information's a little bit muddy. But now it seems that with this supposed restructuring, if money isn't as great as it could be, NC Soft is seeking to reclaim that control, and we'll see that they have more influence on these things. What does that actually mean for us as players? A lot of people are very cynical and worried because NC Soft and NC Softwest don't necessarily have great reputations. I do think that's in large part because people tend to conflate NC Soft with NC Softwest's actions when they're not necessarily a part of the same groups. But for us as the players, you know, I'm not quite as cynical as the everyman, because as far as I remember, all the way through Guild Wars 1 and even the early Guild Wars 2 days, I think that was the situation we were in. And I love the game and the franchise during those times, so I will be optimistic and hold off my prejudice for now. Then the article concludes by saying that apparently, at the time of them posting it, later that afternoon, Mike O was going to have a meeting with staff to discuss those layoffs, and I'll get to that in a second. Kotaku suggests also that for the past few years, ArenaNet has been working on a number of unannounced projects. But again, that's just according to someone anonymous at the studio, and we really don't have much more detail than that. So, the meetings did happen, it seems. Kotaku later updated their article. We have some tweets from a couple of individuals. I think one in particular I know about, Jennifer Schuhl, whose Twitter handle describes her as a lead game designer at ArenaNet, but I'm not actually sure I've ever really seen her in an interview or on a stream or anything. Maybe that's just because I'm not catching the streams well enough. But she does seem to confirm things here with this tweet saying, "Now that our company meetings are over, yes, ArenaNet has announced layoffs today. We are not being shuffled out right away. Decisions are pending. ArenaNet has been very, very transparent with us today in the meetings, which is something I appreciate very much. Whenever these things happen, we at a company level, as well as the industry as a whole, are very raw, very vulnerable. We will support each other as we always do. I wish I didn't have to learn about these things from other people, especially externally." I can only imagine hearing that in a Kotaku article and then having the news dawn on you. Absolutely ridiculous. And an aspect, a dimension of this, I guess we don't have to worry about too much as players. So that's the information. To speak to that last side of things as a player, what do I think this will actually translate into as we move forwards? I'm not entirely sure, honestly. My reading of the room is this is more about ArenaNet's unannounced in-development projects that are in some kind of hell and haven't manifested into any revenue for the company for so long. So one thing I'm thinking about is the big number we're all dealing with at the moment is 400. ArenaNet has about 400 employees, and that's employees, not necessarily designers, right? And people that are all directly working on games, but the company itself has about 400 employees. Now that number we've known for about 2 to 3 years, but it hasn't always been that way. I remember when Guild Wars 2 was coming out in 2012 that the number we were dealing with was 300, itself a massive expansion from the Guild Wars 1 days. But 300 was kind of the big number for many years, and through Living World Season 1 and whatnot, I believe it was around there, until eventually we started hearing it was 400. So there's been an improvement of about 100 new hires over Guild Wars 2's development life. And yet, what have we actually seen that's changed for the game itself? Not necessarily too much. I think that a lot of the expansion that's been going on there hasn't necessarily even been affecting Guild Wars 2 development. And that's something several of us have been grumpy about over the years. I've kind of always accepted they probably had to work on something in the background. So it's reasonable to assume that this extra 100 inflation or so, a lot of it is in name of supporting their next unannounced secretive project or projects that are in limbo. So when it comes to being a Guild Wars 2 player and the prospect and horizon for Guild Wars 2, if the problems are with whatever other stuff they've got in development and now they need to fall back on it, maybe that's the stuff that's going to get hit more than what we're experiencing. Maybe the reason the size of the expansions are the size that they are and Living World releases are the size they are and stuff is because the Guild Wars 2 development teams are already quite squeezed. That's why we have so few World versus World developers and so few people on the PvP team, and things feel quite limited in a lot of ways. What could happen here is there will be layoffs, but Guild Wars 2 development and support, as it exists as a bubble within ArenaNet, might not get poked or popped too much because it's more those other things that are going on. I actually think the way that the Living World teams work and rotate in and out is a very delicate balance, and to mess with the size of those teams and to play with that too much could be really, really damaging. We saw how much work and time it took for the devs to find their feet with all of that cadence and speed that they work at. So I can only imagine the management would be quite reticent to fiddle around with it too much and essentially throw even more stuff, the groundwork they laid during the season 2 days, also in the bin. That's the most optimistic I can be about this, that essentially there's stuff going on in the background that's been mishandled and now they need to get a reins on it, and hopefully it won't affect our baby, the MMO itself, too much. Hopefully. But that, I do admit, is probably a lot more optimistic than most of you guys are feeling, and still, frankly, isn't great. It's still to acknowledge potential incompetence and mismanagement with whatever their other projects are. Isn't a good look for the company. I know none of us are fans of whatever their new IPs might have or could have been, but I certainly would be excited at the prospect of those, and we're even saying here, look, this stuff might not manifest at all in the end. A real shame that I hope ArenaNet can be a little bit more transparent about as we go forwards, though I understand maybe if they aren't. Speaking of ArenaNet transparency, there is a message directly from them on the forums. It's a locked thread where no one can comment. I think the devs know how dangerous and scary and toxic the conversation can get very quickly. MMOs are a weird thing because they're so community-oriented and so built around having high populations that if players get a whiff that the game is dying, that can trigger a mass exodus that wouldn't have happened otherwise. You know, it's a self-fulfilling prophecy. So I think the devs are trying to be very careful about what they say. But we do get a message from the ArenaNet team here, and it says simply, "We know you have a lot of questions about the future of Guild Wars 2. We want to share with you what to expect moving forward for the game. First and foremost, we are still fully committed to all our players and ongoing support of the game. We will be moving directly from Living World Season 4 into Season 5 as promised, and we plan to continue a regular cadence of updates and releases. We know that Guild Wars 2 is important to you, and as our players, you are important to us. Rest assured that we are still working to add great new content to the game. We are deeply grateful to all of you and your support during this difficult time." That's their message that they close out with. I will just say, to me, this doesn't really mean anything. I think this will probably quell fears in the shallow-minded of us out there who think because of this news, that means we're not going to get an episode 6, as if that's, you know, at all on the cards. Episode 6 will have been in development for ages now. Many aspects of the next season will have been in development for ages now. Just because they're planning some layoffs, it doesn't mean everything is being torpedoed and Guild Wars 2 will never have another update. So what the devs are basically revealing to us here is what common sense reveals to us in the first place, that they will at least go up to season 5. But beyond season 5, now that's where things start to get a bit scary. The idea of getting an expansion at all, will we ever get to go to Kantha? These are the big questions that now I must say, even myself, I have these niggling doubts. Surreal stuff, pretty scary, particularly as someone who's dedicated the past few years of his working life to covering this franchise. I have to say, I'm not feeling the best right now. Thanks very much for watching, guys. Let me know what you think, and I'll try to keep you in the loop as best I can as more information unfolds. See you next time. We'll be right back.